हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो टुडे वी विल स्टडी लेक्चर 6 ऑन पीएचपी विच इज़ वेरिएबल स्कोप एंड सुपर ग्लोबल एरेज इन पीएचपी। सो द फर्स्ट प्रोग्राम वी विल सी इज दिस वन विच आई हैव कॉपीड इन shriram.php। सो दिस इज द प्रोग्राम एंड इन इट फर्स्ट वी आर असाइनिंग जय श्री राम टू वेरिएबल एक्स and then we are defining a function in which we are printing x and then we are invoking that function, that is calling that function, that is we are calling that function in this our PHP program. So let us see what is the result. This is the result. So it is giving some undefined variable x. So x is not defined in a function. So basically within this braces there is, this is the definition of this function. So in the definition of this function, x is mentioned here only, nowhere else x is mentioned. So this function does not know what is x. So but x is defined in our main program. So this is called global scope, and this whole thing is called a function scope of the function a, basically in this case. So and outside means openly something is written, then it is called global scope. So if we want to access this x, then we have to first mention that x is a global variable, that is a variable which is present in the global scope, and then we can print x. So it will now print correctly. Jai Shri Ram is printed as expected. So this was the concept of global scope. Or there is one more thing we can do. We can use this globals array. So we can write like this. We need not write this line. We will write like this: dollar globals like this. So this is the super global array globals, which contains all the global variables, and we are referencing this array with the value x. So it will give us the value of the variable x, that is Jai Shri Ram. So it will print it basically. So that is the same output we are getting. So these are the two ways by which we can access the global variables, that is the openly defined variables in our function. So let's see the vice versa thing now, which is to access the variables defined in a function outside that function. So this is the vice versa thing. So let us copy this program. Okay, now I'm pasting here. Okay, so this is a function a. Here we define two variables, we assign them values Jai Shri Ram and Jai Hanuman respectively, and then we return one of the variables, and then we execute a outside the function. So from the main we are calling a, and the result we are getting, that is the returned value, that is dollar y, here we are assigning to a variable dollar z, which is outside this function. So the scope of dollar z is outside this function. So basically z will be assigned the value returned by this function, which is Jai Hanuman in this case. So if we echo z, Jai Hanuman will be printed. So line 4 there is some error. Jai Shri Ram. Okay, Jai Shri Ram, comma, one sec, unexpected comma. Okay, so there is no need of this comma here. We cannot assign it like this. Okay, so now it is okay. we can add a new line here only, equals z comma br. Okay, so now it will work perfectly. Jai Hanuman is printed. Okay, so basically we are printing z here. What if we print y? We will get some error, undefined variable y. So the y is defined inside this function, so it is undefined outside this function. So we can access only those variables outside a function which are returned by the function. So what if we want to return more than one variables from a function? So let us see. So we will use an array in that case. So if I want to return both of these, then I will use an array like this. Return array x comma y. And to retrieve both of these values, I cannot do simply z is equal to a. I can do this also, but I can either retrieve them in a list like this, list z comma m is equal to a. Then what will happen is that z will be assigned the value, first value returned by the function, that is Jai Shriram, and m will be assigned the second value returned by the function, that is Jai Hanuman. So this is the thing. And then another way to do this is assign z the value a returned by function a, and then execute like this $z0. That is, we are printing here the zeroth index of a, of z. So it will print Jai Shriram, and then we will give a line break and then we will print the second value returned by the function. As I told you, the indexing is starting from 0, because counting starts from 0 in a computer. So let us see this. So Jai Shriram is printed, and then Jai Hanuman is printed. The first element returned in the array, second element. Okay. So what is left? Yeah, the last thing I want to tell you today is this program, this small program, which is very simple. So similar to this global $globals super global array, there is one more array called $server in the PHP. So if I execute this function, see, the name of the server which you are visiting is localhost. So this $server is a super global array which can be accessed from anywhere in the program, PHP program, and then you are referencing it with HTTP host. That is, you are retrieving the value of HTTP host corresponding to your server. So I am running this program on localhost, that is Apache server, so it is printing localhost. So if you are running on some far server, like if the program is running on Facebook server, then facebook.com server, then it will be printed the name of the server which you are visiting is Facebook, like this. So thank you friends.